First of good evening, everyone. First of all, on behalf of Waygate Technologies, I would like to welcome you for this session. And we would like to tell you have a wonderful Christmas and a happy new year 2021. Today, my subject is on predictive corrosion management. So this is primarily for wherever the corrosion is there. One second, please. So, predictive corrosion management is primarily for anything which you want to do a permanently installed sensors on challenges like pipes, elbows, headers, and straight runs. And this system is ATEX zone certified, where you have a zone zero locations where you need this system. And the advantage of this corrosion, predictive corrosion, is primarily for you don't have to use coupling, no adhesives or welding used for installations. So it is primarily for continuous monitoring and analysis while in service. Eliminates personal safety hazards from extreme temperatures, combustible gas, toxic vapors and radiations. Continuous monitors for corrosions and erosions. Feeds data to cloud-based software for real-time visibility. Another thing is it avoids how to minimize the downtime. It avoids time-based inspections and more accurately planned maintenance based on conditions and risk profiles. So what is that hardware it contains? So predictive corrosion monitoring, if you look at that, the system layout is very simple, and you need, this is the test specimen, and there is a moat devices, and from moat manager, it will all go to the moat manager. From there, it will go to the cloud and it will go to the system. So need to monitor dynamic corrosion rates, high quality automated thickness data, cloud-based software, possibility of predictive wall loss analytics. What is the current challenges for customers? If you look at that, globally, the corrosion is giving you a cost of $2.5 trillion. This is the estimated one. And annual oil and gas cost for corrosion is close to $200 billion. So this opportunity of predictive corrosion management systems will reduce at least by 15 to 35% on your total cost. So comprised asset integrity and receptor protection. So even you are in productions, you don't have to worry. And hazardous emissions, environmental damage, risk to personal and community, damage to public reputation. So these are all the challenges you have. These are all the loss currently incurred by oil and gas and then other fertilizers industries so far. Challenge to managing corrosion risk. So first thing is you need to monitor dynamic corrosion rates and then need to ability to predict impact of operational challenges, hindered in implementing risk-based inspection mitigation strategy, inability to leverage ultrasonic testings data for risk-based inspection, quality of manual collected thickness measurements, cost associated with inspection programs. So these are all the challenges you'll be having. PCM core, what it is? It's a very simple device. One is with the hardware, second one is the software, and third one is the services. So if you look at the hardware, the Ritrax PM installed UT sensors for repeatable, accurate readings. So your objective is to get an accurate reading and also repeatability, and the mesh networks of moats, cellular of WAN connectivity, designed for safety. So it is ATEX certified and FM approved one. And software will provide you proactive maintenance. So corrosion and temperature data stored as full A-scan UT data, trending analysis and exporting, input to risk-based inspections, cloud-based program solution extending asset performance, management and Meridium suite. And services, what they can support is site survey, sensor installations, software updates, support for life of subscriptions. So what exactly, how it does that ultrasonic? So primarily what you do is you have a sensor technology to detect the corrosions. And this sensor technology, once detect the corrosion, the data transmission technology to move data and cloud-based software to analyze data across facilities. So wherever you are there, you can do that. And differentiator, how we differentiate low profile sensors, and battery life is very long, more than 5 years. No acoustic couplant or hard work is needed. Operational expenses versus capex expenditure is very nominal, cloud powered. What is the outcome as a customer you get? That is what is important for a customer. So improve visibility to critical assets integrity, monitor impact of operational decision as an asset integrity, feed data to predictive analytics, feed data to risk-based inspection program, and simplify compliance. So if you look at the right side of the diagram, you can see how it is mounted. So you'll be mounting a multiple sensors, and it can operate from 2-inch to 75-inch diameter of the pipe. And well, depends upon the diameter and the size of the things, the moat, and we'll have a 64 sensors. You have a wireless connections at multiple location. And then every moat will be communicating to the moat manager, and moat manager will take up the data to the system. From the system, it goes to the cloud. So frequent and repeatable measurements, why is this important? Because in corrosion, if you look at that, it is not that earlier method of inspection is just once in 6 months or once in a year, or when there is a real challenge, when they found something, then they would like to see what is the corrosion rate. But if you look at this system, what it will do is there is a continuously, periodically from month on month, or once in 3 months or once in 4 months, depends upon the severity of your product which is going into the pipe and how the corrosion level takes place as per your experience. It keeps telling you this one. But the more sensors you mount on each and every pipe, the better the data you'll be getting. So looking to identify wall loss rate down to the mill, having more data point is always better for establishing trends. You can see again why this is important. If you look at the corrosion, current corrosion rate, where we have taken only a very less sensor, and it will just give you a straight line. So it means that technically you will feel, okay, nothing has happened. But when you same thing, when you do it with 50 miles per year, when you have multiple sensors and multiple data points, you can see a clear cut variations, and you know how the variation actually taking place. Whereas in this first case, at the very beginning itself, it shows as a straight line, and it is. But if you look at that, the graph, you will know how exactly it is changing in periodical manner. So these are all the three different conditions we have taken. One is with the current corrosion rate with 0 mils per second. Another one is with 50 mils per year. And third one is 600 mils per year. And you can see on the right-hand side and the left-hand side, the different points and locations, looking to identify wall loss rates down to the mill. So your primary importance is how much corrosion is taking place in the pipe, and whether it has to be repaired or it has to be replaced, or the condition as its status quo, let it run. So having more data point is always better for establishing trend. Corrosion rates are viable. So this is, again, I'm coming back how the hardware looks like, which I have already explained to you. This is what your test specimen, and then there is a moat. So it can go up to 100 per moat manager, and you will have some wireless data. From that, it is going to the moat manager. From moat manager, it will go to that internet switch. From there, it will go to the mini field agent, which is the IoT gateway. From there, it will go to the cloud-based. And all our ATX zone, ATX area location. And if you look back where exactly, so the main area is ATX, and then non-ATX, and then office or the control room where you can specify. Now coming back to the sensors. So the real challenge as a customer is on what is the temperature I can go, whether how much your ultrasonic can withstand. So till 6 months before, Vega Technology developed a sensor which can go up to 200 degree. Now we have special sensors, depends upon your temperature. Suppose if you say that you have a temperature of 300 to 350 or 380 or 400, we do have a very specialized high sensors which can withstand up to 400 degree. and non-coupland, no coupland sensor. It is a patented technology. Solgel comprises stainless steel strap tightened to permanently confirm Solgel active element or the probe. And the layer is 8 mm square, so which is a very small one. And you can see this dimension on the right side, what you can see. And there is absolutely no coupland is required. And how we strip in the pipe. So this is how we do. We use a very special strap, so which will allow your sensor to completely, permanently mount in the specimen. So wherever it is, once we fix it, it will be permanently mounted. And it can withstand up to 400 degree temperature. These are some examples. So extra probe protections, easy to install. So the idea is to protect the probe, because probe is the heart of the system. And that is the one which is giving you the complete signal and data. And it is completely mounted and temperatures, whole probe and wire connections. So large diameter, suppose if you have a diameter of over 50 or 60 or 70, we do have a special system designed with the probe, which can go up to 24 to 72 inch. And the temperature can go start from 40 degree to 400 degrees Celsius. And double strap, so it will be completely protected. Lab testing completed, and it is already in the field. And if you look at that, mold design certified for intrinsic safety, all 8X zone certified, and all the classification as per the global classifications, this is completely certified. And just to give you a wireless network, how it will be behaving. If you look at that, the mode manager is a wireless controller. That is the one connecting to the multiple modes. And there will be a mode network. So modes will find fastest route to the manager. So whichever it is there, it will immediately go. You can have multiple modes and then it will go to the mode manager. From there it will go. So 400 meter between the antenna with a clear line of sight. That is one condition required when you are keeping this mode and mode manager properly. So every mode can control up to 100 modes per manager. So if you have multiple modes, then you'll have a different managers, multiple managers. So what type of wall loss and where does Precium provides value? This is one important questions which most of the customers will ask. Wall loss due to general corrosions. If you take refineries, the maximum corrosion happening in crude lines and naphthenic acid. If you're taking in petrochemical, chemical plants, hydrofluoric acid, and normal utilities, microbiological corrosions, and in upstream gathering lines, central processing facilities. These are all the some of the wall loss to general corrosions. Similarly, wall loss due to erosion also takes place, like flow accelerated corrosions and high velocity stream and refineries, sand and cube. And applications. Variety of crudes with varying acid and total acid number content result in rapid, unpredictable wall loss. PCM contributes early detection of accelerated wall loss. So your ultimate objective is again and again to measure the wall loss. Heavy crude vacuum header line, this is one area where the wall loss happening very fast. Then distillation unit headers and flow headers. Similarly, sand in crude, if you look at that, can cause significant unpredictable erosion at T-junctions, all the T-junctions. Alarm triggers at minimum thickness level. So PCM can eliminate the need for periodic manual UT measurements. Because nowadays, wherever possible, people wants to avoid manual UT inspections. And not only that, and in most of the cases in zone certified, zone zero, manual entry is completely avoided. So you can use, this is a very good technology which can help you to give complete data with more informations. And how we do the installation part. So this is something which as a customer, what is required from us is you need to, The coating, if any coating is there, the coating should be removed. Then we will put Mentor UT used pinpoint sensors of location. So we will have multiple sensors. We will pinpoint each and every areas, and then we will permanently install with the high quality stamp. So you can see how we have installed, how we have done installing the sensors, preliminary analysis of A scan. So whatever the A scan data which you already have, we have that, and then we will start measuring with this current A scan data and informations. So how Moat Manager look? So we will be positioning this. You can see this on the right side. Moat installed at H-bar locations at multiple refineries where you'll have similar facilities where it will be mounted very strongly and 7 meters above the asset level. And then you can also see, this is the white one is the antenna and this is the Moat. So there will be a clear line of sight. Moat Manager installed on the top of the control room. The bag on the installed Moat with relatively clear line of sight. So this is at the control room. This is at the line of sight where the Moat is installed. This is the place where the Moat is installed. So PCM installation, I have explained to you, mini field agent housed in control room, how it will be in control room. LAN port connects to the Moat Manager outside, which we have shown with Ethernet cable. Then mini field agent sends data to cloud over cellular network primarily used. Thus WAN port unused in this example is not used PCM software. So what data as a customer you will get cloud-based software. So we have a very high quality software, the wall thickness measurement. So it will give you the digital capabilities. So primarily as a digital solution company, we provide temperature corrected wall thickness measurements, temperature chart, full UT A-scan data. So you'll also be getting the complete A-scan data and then short-term and long-term corrosion rates. So it will predict you 3 months before how was your corrosion rate and how your corrosion rate today and next 3 months, how it is going to different, how it going to behave. So that will help as a customer when you want to repair, when you want to replace, when you want to continue. So this will help you to reduce your cost substantially by several million dollars. And more than that, the time and the safety of the human. So this is how the data will come. And you can see how the A-scan data, the initial pulse, what exactly, and then you'll see the first back wall echo, and then the second back wall echo. And then you will see whether if there is a loss in corrosions, then it will immediately give you the details. So software features, so measuring point forecast, projected life of the sensor, select a sensor and plot short-term or long-term corrosion rate, number of days to reach the critical level, and then you can have that alert. So numerous defect fix and ultrasonic improvement launched in the process. So wireless protocol, and cloud security details. The PCM corrosion detection systems operate a private segregated wireless mesh network for sensor data aggregation. This network is managed by Moat Manager, which we explained earlier, provides sensor signal to predicts cloud to perform the thickness. So PCM does not offload data locally. Data is directly uploaded into the cloud via Ethernet. So PCM software has undergone penetration testings. Various testing methods has been done. So this is again, I'm giving you the final version, how it looks like. And what are the protocol based, which we have mentioned, communication between the Moat and the gateway is in the private mesh networks. Lean and mean, get the most data with smallest pull on battery. Use of this protocol with IoT players, leading way. PCM complies to wireless protocol standard. This is the one. Meets AES standard security standards. So as per all the cyber security norms, it complies, does not compete or interfere with other protocols in your locations. And more efficient data management, lower cost, individually addressable IP address for each point in network, and very high security and very high battery life, the system. So this is just to give you a wall loss analytics. So most of you who are in this field, especially in oil and gas and fertilizers, they'll be more interested to know. So material attributes, equipment material characteristics. So you can see the metrology, wall thickness and pressure rating. What is the containment composition? So sulfur, FeH2S, acids, HCl, then NH3 and other things. What are the operating environment, pressure and temperature, and wall thickness measurement from the installed sensors. So it predicts wall loss predictions to unique nature of each thickness measurement locations, confidence interval calculated and provided for each predictions, scenario modeling based on current and anticipated operating decision to understand the impact of opportunity crude and other factors there. So this is a predictive analysis. Still we are doing continuously improving on various things. Predictive analytical forecasts. So what digital-based digital capabilities, if analysis for scenario comparison and the predictive model. So this is another one, what we are into. So cloud-based model in conjunction with BS assess potential for corrosion in top of cover, overhead piping, overhead condensers, and assess whether reflux with the problem, water wash systems is properly operating. So this is the high temperature probe, which we have already explained. It is already completed and for up to 430 degrees continuously operated. Installed procedure defined and tested in a controlled environment. Trials completed. And this is the final one, 24 to 72 inch is that, 400 degree temperatures, lab tested. So we are continuously improving based on client requirements and trying to do whatever they are interested in terms of strategy, inspect, analytic and actions and risk performance risk analysis. And the system is in fully functionable and it is risk-based. You may identify damage mechanism, asset to install sensors, develop chemical program based on risk. So inspections, we have already explained. Connect and collect data, install sensors, visual inspection results, thickness data, entity results, pastures, process historian. Risk-based inspection specifically for thickness monitoring, inspection management, and management of change. So value staircase, which will give you the primary goal is a saving and then improve asset performance. So 15% asset life extension. It means extended asset life of 6 to 18 months. Optimized process and operations, 15% improvement in process efficiency, extended runtime, optimization, corrosion inhibitions. So crude overhead applications, I'm just giving you a case study how it is. So most of you must be familiar on these things. So we need to keep multiple sensors, depends upon your locations, and then take data. These are more examples of a bent pipe and a normal pipe. You see that how it is, how the sensors was being strapped and mounted on each and every locations, installation designed, where to apply the PCM, corrosion prone zones, and sensors heat resistance less than 400 degree, and pipe OD is 72 inch at present. But however, if there is something higher, we can look into, but depends upon the severity of your product. So finally, this is our core team. So my name is Shankar Narayanan. So I'm responsible for the South Asia for this technology and our product manager from Netherlands and Mr. Michael and Neil is from UK, Ireland, and Yogita is from US. So this is about our team in India, myself and Sujit is there. Thank you. If any questions, anything, you can ask.